Please like and comment on the video below. That will allow me to produce better quality videos and more of them in the future. If you're interested in learning to trade successfully on sports, then why not visit the BetAngel Academy, where we have more detailed videos.
So when you use BetAngel, you'll be presented with the screen, and you often see my videos look similar to this main screen, and your screen may look similar to it as well. But there's actually an infinite number of ways in which you can configure and display the information within BetAngel. To get an understanding of, typically when I record a video, I record it like this because it's standard and people can modify the base version of BetAngel into whatever they want to. And I don't want to display all of the complexity of it. So I would encourage you to play around with all of the options that you've got available to make it just perfect for exactly what you want. You're not obliged to stick with what we have here. You can change it the way that you want. But also there's some hidden depth in terms of the way that BetAngel operates that will help you get the most out of it. And by that, I mean, you've got the main application in front of you here, and this is nice and easy to get access to all of the things that you need. But you don't have to use BetAngel specifically like this. Typically, when you look at BetAngel, you're looking at two main applications. The main interface that you see when you first turn it on, and you've got Guardian as well. Now, Guardian, automation, watch lists, all singing, all dancing, does loads of amazing things. It's a piece of software in its own right. Explore that independently of the main application, because what you've effectively got here are two bits of software that run independently from each other doing two different things. And you may sort of think that maybe Guardian is just for multi-market stuff, but that's not necessarily the case, because you can do multi-market stuff on the main application as well while Guardian is working around. In fact, you can close Guardian down and that will do all of its magic in the background for you without disturbing what you're doing on the main interface. But let's dig around here and I'll show you how to bring up and display multiple markets on the main interface as well. So let's give that a go now. So in order to understand how we can do that, I'm going to do something unusual here. I'm actually going to get rid of the main application just to highlight to you exactly what is going on. But in order to do that, I need to have a way of selecting markets. So if I do File, Select Market, we bring up the market selection tool. I've already pinned this, but this is the unpinned state. This is the pinned state. I'm going to pin that to the top so that remains visible constantly. And I'm actually going to grab the main application here, and we're actually going to move it off of the main screen here. So now we have a blank canvas effectively. So the main application refreshes the market that you're looking at and that you're actively trading on BetAngel. And everything else sort of can run off of that. But Guardian sits in the background and runs independently of that. So like I said before, you've got two bits of software effectively to use, and how you choose to use them is entirely up to you. But if we get to the market selection screen and put it over on the left-hand side here, I can sort of expand that into just looking at all of the individual markets that are possible. But what I can also do, if I just drag down BetAngel again, I can undock the ladder if I want to, and then pull that down over here. And then I can actually create a ladder display that ticks away up here, perhaps. Now, because of the screen space that we're trying to fit stuff on, you probably would want to use separate sort of settings. So if we want to display the ladder interface in a different format, that's very, very easy to you. Use the ladder settings editor over here. Or perhaps, we modify some element of it to allow us to display a ladder that is sort of perfect for whatever we're attempting to do within that market. But say, for example, we're trading football. If I search for, in fact, I don't need to search for it because I've done it already. If I search for the Arsenal v whatever that team is called match, we can bring that up on the screen. Now, did you see there that the market selection vanished? So if I go to File, Select a Market, if you go to Settings, you can define the behavior of the market tree. So I'm going to say don't hide it. I'm going to untick the hide when switching to a market. And we're going to display that market, the market selection screen permanently on the left, and other stuff is going to be displayed on the right. So when we're looking at this particular football match, there are a few things that we could do. So the match odds are three runners, basically. So that would sort of fit well on a ladder, wouldn't it? So I'm going to take BetAngel off and put it on another screen somewhere. We will hide that for the moment. But what I'm interested in looking for as well, if we, I'm going to redefine this search here, and I'm going to say Europa League and Arsenal. And we could actually prefix this with today's date if we wanted to bring up Europa League Arsenal on this particular day, but it's brought in all of the markets that we require anyway. So we've got the ladder up at the top of the screen. Now, if we want to, we can get rid of elements of the top of the screen here as well. So if we go into the ladder settings area, we can actually change the way that information is displayed here. So if we wanted to, we could get rid of certain elements of the ladder. We can change the way that the staking is done if we want to modify that sort of behavior. There are loads of settings in there that you can modify. But you could also, if you right click up here, can you see you've got settings, market title. We know it's an Arsenal match. Do we want really the market volume? Maybe we're not interested in that. Other information, the countdown timer, perhaps we don't want that. So you can see there are different ways of modifying the content that you have at the top of the ladder. There's another video that I've done showing you how you can modify every single aspect of the ladder in terms of adding, removing columns, the display of information above and below. There are many different ways of doing that. But basically, we now have the match odds on the ladder in front of us. If you resize the ladder, then that will actually automatically change the number of cells that you're looking at within there. So this is quite helpful in terms of the way that you would display information. You could scrunch it up, you could make the fonts a little bit smaller, you can make it bigger, you could do whatever you like with it, basically. Display more ladders, less ladders. There's an infinite amount of variety that you could display from there. But the reason that I'm doing this is because I want to show you how you can sort of merge and change a couple of things within there as well. So if we go in to the market tree here, what I can actually do is if I right click, you can see I can display the market on the one click screen on the ladder screen. But can you see I've also got two options down here as well? I can display the market in a new ladder and a new one click screen. So for example, if we look at the correct score market, you've got like 450 million individual markets within there. That probably won't display as well on a ladder. Now you could get it done there. You could actually do like multiple ladders on one pane. But what I'm going to do here, just for demonstration purposes, is display it on a new one-click window. So you can see here, we could actually then dock this underneath the display. We're going to resize it to make it fit within here. But of course, you can modify every element with inside the one-click screen. So you can move columns around, shrink, expand, delete stuff, add custom columns, add stored values, and all sorts of other information to have that immediately available within the one click screen. So all of these views, not only can you adjust and modify them in terms of the display, you can modify the content of the ladder and the one click screen. You can even add in custom information to them as well on BetAngel. So you can see now, if I pin this here, we'll just make sure that all of this stays exactly where it is. And say perhaps I'm interested in the over and under 2.5 goal market. So we'll find it down here. And what I'm going to do here is spawn a new ladder with that information within it. It's appeared on the screen off to my left here. So I'm just going to pull that across. So if we want to display over and under 2.5 goals, the correct score market, and the one-click screen. You understand where I'm coming from. Match odds, correct score, over and under market, all on the same screen. You can see we've created this lovely layout here where we're looking at a particular football match, and all of that information is displayed in and around it. But the wonderful thing about this is we still actually have the main screen active as well. So we can park that on another screen somewhere, have all of the information immediately in front of us, and then as the match is underway, we can use the main screen for whatever we want to, and this screen for this particular match. So in fact, you could have an infinite number of monitors, but perhaps not infinite, with all of this information displayed specifically on it. And you can be looking at one match on one individual screen. But once you've done that, if you go into the view option here, let me just pull this across so we can get it all on the same screen. I've actually got multiple screens here, but I have to record on one. You can actually save the screen layout as. a particular type. So move the main app off there, Guardian over here, Excel into the top left-hand corner, and then your main trading interfaces on one screen right in front of you. And then you can call that layout whatever you want. My amazing football layout. And then basically when you go back to another market in the future, or you start up the application tomorrow, next week or whenever, all of this is carefully laid out for you. And you just need to go in and specify obviously the markets that sit within this particular layout. And away you go from there. So yeah, you can modify the one-click screen and the components of the one-click screen. You can modify the ladder, but you don't have to run it within the main application or within Guardian. You can actually spawn individual markets out of the market tree in the way that I've just done on this video, and have all of that information available for you immediately to hand. And it means that you can have the screen set up exactly the way that you want with all the markets that you need right in front of you. BetAngel is incredibly flexible, incredibly customizable, and it's designed that way so that you can get the best out of whatever you're trading and however you are trading those individual markets.